Hello and welcome to today's class. We are going to discuss the unit called Introduction to Journalism. As you know, journalism is a form of communication or disseminating information on behalf of the audiences. And we say that when you want to disseminate information as a journalist, or else when you want to communicate as a journalist, you must always look for reliable sources of information, and you must ensure that your information is credible before you disseminate to the members of the targeted audiences. So today we are just going to measure on the elements of communication. Because you know, human being is always a social being and must always be able to communicate. So there are five main basic elements of communication. And one of the main elements of communication is what we call the message. The message will mean that you must be having an idea of what you want to communicate about, or else what we want to talk about. There's no way you can disseminate information or communicate information without having the prior idea of what you are going to talk about. Maybe let's say you want to talk about a feature story, you want to discuss about a documentary, or is a news story. So you must be having an idea behind your brain before you happen to disseminate information to your targeted audiences. So the first element of communication you are saying is what you call the message. And you are saying the message will be the theme or the topic of discussion of the content that you want to share with your targeted audiences. Then you have what is called, the second one is what you call the sender. The sender simply is someone who is packaging that particular content, or is someone who encodes the message that is supposed to be sent to the targeted audiences. So the sender must be someone who has the prior content about the topic of discussion, must be someone who have an idea. Once you have your idea, you package your idea, and you as a sender, once you understand the nature of your targeted audiences, you are going to send the message to your recipient, or else they receive that particular message. So you must have a sender. There's no way someone can receive a message without someone sending to him or to her. So a sender is a very vital person in an element, or else in a communication process, whereby without a sender, there's no way a message can be communicated. Then after having a sender, have the recipient of the message. The receiver is simply someone who decodes the encoded message, because once the sender sends a message, he expects that you are able to understand. And the only way you can be able to understand the message is by giving the message the most appropriate meaning. But if you cannot give a message a meaning, it means you're not able to understand the message and you are likely to give a negative feedback. But now, communication is only effective when the sender is able to understand the nature or the meaning of the message that was disseminated by the sender. So the receiver, the main purpose of the receiver in the communication process is to decode the encoded message, or is to decode the sent message from the sender of that particular information. So the receiver goes through the content and gives the exact meaning, just the same as the one that had been packaged by the sender. The receiver and the sender must always be sailing in the same port for them to be able to understand each other. Then after the receiver have something, or else what you call the medium. There's no way a message can be sent without having a specific channel of communication. There must be a medium that always ensure that the message has been sent from the sender to the receiver. The medium is like an in-between, or is an interlinking factor between the sender and the receiver. And the medium used is determined by the urgency of the message, the cost of the medium, or the nature of the message that you're disseminating to your targeted audiences. We have some information are private, need to use appropriate medium, or it's a private medium. We have some information are supposed to be for the mass audiences. So you have to use mass audience as a medium of communication. So the channel you are going to use is also determined by the nature of your targeted audiences, because we have some people cannot be able to read newspapers, so you cannot send a message by use of a newspaper. We have those who can only understand vernacular radio station, so you are supposed to use a vernacular radio station in order to be able to reach them, or else to achieve your targeted objective. So once you have chosen the most appropriate media, depending on the urgency of the message, for example, a post office can take a whole week, but a radio maybe you can just send a message immediately. You can make a telephone call, which is going to be effective, or else it use little amount of time for you to be able to disseminate your messages. So once you have already used appropriate medium of communication, for any communication to be effective, there must be what you call a feedback. Filter simply means the receiver now is responding to the message that you had already sent previously. And you have two main types of feedback. Feedback can either be positive or feedback can be negative. When someone happens to send a positive feedback, it means he is in compliance with what you are saying, or else you are sailing in the same port. Now, if you are having a negative feedback, it means two of you are not in agreement, or else the sender of the message and the receiver of the message are in a disagreement. And out of that, someone is going to give a negative feedback. A negative feedback can also be given as a result of misunderstanding or as misinterpretation. For example, let's say the receiver did not decode the message the way it was expected. All right, the receiver did not give the meaning to the message the way the meaning was supposed to be disseminated. So the receiver is going to give a negative feedback, and out of negative feedback, it means that communication has not been that effective. So without a feedback, communication is still incomplete. But a feedback can either be negative or else can be positive. And you are saying that a positive feedback is whereby you are in compliance with the sender of the message. But a negative feedback is whereby you are in disagreement with the sender of that particular message. Still, under communication, there is an element called noise or distractor, or else the external environment or the field of experience. Field of experience can be as a result of noise. Maybe you are disseminating information at a noisy environment, or is the external environment is very noisy, and out of that, maybe someone is not hearing or is not able to understand what you are talking about. And this one majorly applies to oral communication. Still, under negative experience can be out of attitude. Maybe let's say someone has a negative attitude towards you. However, though you package the message, he will never take that particular message in a positive way. So this under form we call a field of experience that normally affect the communication process, or is also a distractor of the communication process. Or else under distractor can be by use of inappropriate means of communication. Maybe you're supposed to send a message via telephone or else make a telephone call, but now you're using a post office, which means you're using a poor means of communication, and out of that, you're likely to have a distractor in your communication. It can also be caused out of the level of experience from the recipient. Maybe the recipient doesn't have knowledge about the topic of discussion, and out of that, he's going to develop a negative attitude towards your message of communication, and it's likely to be an effective mode of communication. So you have just been highlighting and explaining a few aspects, or the main aspect of elements of communication, and you have said that the first element of communication is there must be an idea, right? There must be a message of communication, and you have said there must be the sender, someone who packaged that particular message. There is a receiver, the one who decodes the message. There is medium of communication, or a channel of communication. And we are saying there is a feedback which can either be positive or else feedback can be negative. But we're also saying that you have what is called field of experience, or else external distractors. And among external distractors, you're talking about noise, which is part of communication, because noise is always accompanied in any form of communication. And you say it can also be a result of negative attitude, or else level of experience, or level of education, or attitude that you have toward the sender of that particular message can affect your understanding capacity of that message. So thank you for your time. I hope you'll be able to apply these skills in real life situation and even in your academic progress. Thank you so much.